terrorists. When this guy King himself, if it's Irish terrorism or Israeli terrorism, it seems to be okay with people in this government and in the Congress and in the White House. But if it's any other kind of terrorism, of course, we're supposed to become the Stasi and inform on everybody.
Oh, yeah, as long as the terrorists are working for them, that's just fine. But, I mean, right. For those who are, you know, loath to blame Rahm for the sins of the father, consider what he did after Bill Clinton's re-election in 1996, which is another famous story. You know, especially in light of all this recent contrived media rhetoric about telling people to tone down the vitriol after the Gifford shooting. Tell the listeners what Rahm Emanuel did during this Clinton re-election celebration in 96.
Well, I mean, there was a couple of weird things. He sent a dead fish to a political opponent. I mean, that's right out of The Godfather, isn't it? I mean, he did everything but, you know, put a horse's head on somebody's front porch. He also stabbed a steak knife into a table, and every time he stabbed the knife into the table, he said, "This one's dead, this one's dead, this one's dead." I mean, this is what you got. I mean, so when I say the kosher version of Sopranos, I'm not exaggerating. This is now, he got his start in getting involved in political campaigns in the 80s, mostly presidential campaigns. There was Senator Paul Simon's campaign for president. He was from Illinois, and there was John Glenn's presidential campaign. So that's how he got in. He's not an attorney. His degree is in public communications. That's his background. But, of course, in Chicago, he was going to go originally to ballet school. You know, he was a ballet dancer. But he wound up going to Sarah Lawrence College instead.
It's a strange leap from being a ballet dancer to a member of the Israeli Defense Force. But going back to that, yeah, that's what I was reading about before. He was jamming the knife in the dinner table and screaming out the name of Clinton's political adversaries, and after each name screaming dead, dead, dead. I mean, talk about violent rhetoric. This is the administration that's lecturing us all about violent rhetoric, and one of the top guys in there comes out with this. Also, there was the incident, and I mean, this is just an insight into how Rahm Emanuel is such a thoroughly pleasant chap. Tell the listeners about the shower incident, which, of course, was featured on this David Letterman clip.
Right. This was during the whole health care bill debate. Representative Eric Mass, a Democrat from New York, was using the House of Representatives gymnasium shower, and where he was confronted by a naked Rahm Emanuel in the shower, who was poking him in the chest with his finger, reading him the riot act about his lack of support for the Obama health care bill. And of course, Massa said, Rahm Emanuel is the kind of person who would strap his own mother onto the front of a steam locomotive if he thought it could get him some political points. Of course, Massive wound up resigning amid this scandal, and it just seems to me that from talking to people very much involved in that whole episode, that Massive was targeted by some political tricks operation operating out of the Obama White House. I mean, I thought we saw enough of that with Karl Rove during the Bush administration. But apparently it was a nice transition where we went from Karl Rove as George Bush's chief hitman to Obama, who had Rahm Emanuel as his chief hitman. And now it looks like we got Bill Daley, who's part of this whole Chicago mafia, coming in as the new Obama chief hitman. Of course, he's probably more concerned about placating the needs of Wall Street, the Goldman Sachs, J.P. Morgan, Stanley, Chase people than anything else. But you look at the whole thing with the takedown of Rod Blagojevich, the governor. He obviously knows a lot about these people: Emanuel, Obama, Valerie Jarrett, Axelrod, Rezko. I mean, Rezko's still in solitary confinement. Although he's been convicted of federal crimes, he's not even in a federal penitentiary. He's in solitary, and I mean, it's like this guy's one of the rendition people from, you know, it's down in Guantanamo.
Exactly. And I mean, by the sounds of it, this is the kind of personality in Rahm Emanuel who would work his way up the political ladder with, you know, brute force and intimidation. From your research, is that the case? Is this how he rose to prominence, or was it merely, you know, political deals with his allies?
Yeah, it's a little bit of both. He made deals, obviously, after he left the Clinton White House. And, you know, Hillary Clinton wanted to fire him in 1993, but it never happened. President Clinton arranged for him to go work for Mac McClarty, chief of staff. But for some reason, Hillary and Rahm Emanuel never got along. And during that 08 campaign, remember, Rahm Emanuel for an awful long time was neutral. He only came out and supported Obama when Obama started winning in some of those caucus states and some of the smaller primaries and started build up some momentum. Then he came out and supported Obama. But this whole thing with Rahm Emanuel, he leaves, takes a job with the Wall Street firm Wasserstein and Perella. And then he makes $16 million there, which, of course, feeds into his congressional campaign in 2002. And the other thing, President Clinton appointed Rahm Emanuel to the board of Freddie Mac, and we know how corrupt all the corruption there with Freddie Mac. So it's possible that Emanuel and the Clintons probably are in a mutually assured destruction situation.
Okay, we'll be back. Final segment with Wayne Madsen after the break. Third hour, Joel Skousen sits in for his hosting debut on The Alex Jones Show. Be sure to stay tuned for that at prisonplanet.tv. This is The Alex Jones Show Live. Stay tuned.
Not all protein supplements are created equal. One World Whey is the first cold temperature processed, 100% all-natural, unrefined, bioactive, grass-pasture-raised milk whey protein. Far from being another ordinary protein supplement, One World Whey is a full-spectrum nutrition power food in and of itself, providing overall life-building benefits that touch virtually every human's life that other protein supplements don't deliver on. What are the benefits? Boosts the immune system, anti-aging properties, helps detoxification, helps reduce body fat, excellent for building lean muscle, increases energy levels, enhances the feelings of youth, sports performance, exercise recovery. Who's it for? Busy people, hardworking executives, students, teachers, active seniors, people recovering from illness, office workers, construction workers, and high-performance athletes. Call 888-988-3325 or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that it could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com. Or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
9 years, thousands of clients worldwide, amazing results. And here's more proof of the effectiveness of how Heart and Body Extract supports good circulation and healthy arterial flow.
My name is Crystal. I'm a 45-year-old and live in Houston, Texas. I was diagnosed with having mitral valve prolapse 10 years ago. My cardiologist said surgery and drugs was the only thing he could offer me.
What did Crystal do?
I ordered Heart and Body Extract in August 2006. When I first took my first 15 drops, I embraced the formula. and could even feel the goodness of the formula starting to work.
Clean, clear arteries are happy arteries after using Heart and Body Extract. Learn more at hbextract.com or call 866-295-5305. That's hbextract.com or call 866-295-5305. HB Extract comes with a 100% ironclad money-back guarantee. Details at hbextract.com or call 866-295-5305 for Heart and Body Extract.
It's V-Day on the Alex Jones Show. Welcome back. Here are the Google search terms once again for today. Google search term number one, you are the resistance. You are the resistance. Search term number two, occupation of America. That's occupation of America. And search term number three, V for victory. V for victory. Get those search terms entered into Google. Get us to the top of Google Trends and more people will discover what we're trying to achieve with this Resistance V for Victory campaign. We're talking with Wayne Madsen, WayneMadsenReport.com, and we're talking about Rahm Emanuel, and I just wanted to touch upon in the final segment what you thought of this scary interview that Emanuel gave in 2006 with Ben Smith of the New York Post, where he says, quote, "We're going to have universal civil defense training somewhere between the ages of 18 to 25. You will do 3 months of training, but there can be nothing wrong with all Americans having a joint similar experience of what we call civil defense training." And then in a later C-SPAN interview, Emanuel said that the civil defense training would be, quote, required of everybody. So they were basically floating a plan for a mandatory civil defense draft, which at the time fused with these fears about Obama's, quote, civilian national security force. Wayne, I mean, what's Rahm's role in pushing this whole civil draft thing? Is it merely a throwback to his IDF days? Can you see something like this coming to pass in America with the right crisis?
Well, certainly. I think it's partly influenced by the fact that everyone has to serve through a draft in Israel. But the whole concept in a country like the United States seems to harken back to the brown shirts of Nazi Germany more than the Israeli draft, military draft. And I think, the rhetoric like that, coupled with, internet kill switches and all the other crazy stuff we hear coming out of this White House from Cass Sunstein and his cognitive infiltration program of websites and groups, I think this goes to show that the Obama administration, in some respects, is actually worse than the previous administration, which may have wanted the Bush-Cheney might have wanted to carry some of this out, but I guess they knew how far they could go. Where this administration figures there is no goalpost here, there is no end zone. They can keep moving the goalpost till they get what they desire, and I think it's. It's something less than what we would recognize as a democracy.
And just finally, for the last couple of minutes, tell people about WayneMadsenReport.com and how they can subscribe to your material there.
Well, it's WayneMadsenReport.com. It's all one word, and they can subscribe through PayPal or by snail mail. Basically, I'm trying to do what Jack Anderson and Drew Pearson did in Washington for many, many years, do the muckraking, get the stories out, the stuff that never gets past the editors, the publishers of the corporate media in this town, because the media in Washington, D.C. is absolutely controlled.
Okay, Wayne Madsen, a pleasure speaking with you. Thanks for your time. We'll be sure to be talking to you again very soon on the Alex Jones Show. Thanks. And it's Joel Skousen coming up in the third hour. in the final hour of the Alex Jones Show. Remember, get your V for Victory resistance posters at prisonplanet.com and infowars.com. Become part of the resistance. Take on the total takeover of society.
On air, online, and on demand, we are the GCN Radio Network.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator.